Welcome to Jijja Academy Lahore. Today we are going to discuss network topologies. Network topology, a physical arrangement of devices in a network, is called network topology. As we have several devices to be connected to a network, so the way we physically arrange those devices is called topology. There are different types of topologies, such as bus topology, star topology, ring topology, tree topology, and mesh topology. Let's discuss them one by one. Bus topology, this is the simplest type of a network. Simplest type means simplest arrangement. All devices are connected to a central wire. Central wire is also called a bus. In this diagram, this is the central wire which is called a bus. Here you see all devices or computers are connected to this central wire. A terminator is used at both ends of a bus. Both ends are one end and the other end. So a terminator is fixed at both ends of the bus. It is a small device that absorbs signals. A collision can occur if two devices communicate at the same time. It means there should be one message on this central wire at a time. If two devices send their messages at the same time, then a collision of messages occur. Now let's discuss the working of a bus topology. All devices that are connected to a network have unique addresses. Suppose this computer's address is A, its address is B, this is C, D, E, and F. The addresses of devices are not like A, B, C. I'm just using alphabetic letters to make it simple. Suppose that computer A wants to communicate with computer F. Then computer A will send its message on this central wire, and the message should contain two types of information. Number one, it's data or message that computer A wants to deliver to the destination computer F along with the address of destination computer. So these two types of information should be sent to the bus. Now this message will move on the central bus and will reach to all computers connected to this central wire. If this message reaches to computer B, it will match the address of the packet of the message, packet or message. As the address is not B, so computer B will ignore the message. Similarly, C, D, E, all will ignore the message because the destination address is not matched to all of them. But computer F will keep this message. It will receive this message because the destination address matches this computer, which is F computer. This is how communication is made in a bus topology. Now let's see the advantages and disadvantages of bus topology. Advantages: very simple and easy connectivity. The second advantage is, if one node is failed, one node means any device connected to the computer. It may be a computer or any other device like printer, scanner, or any device. So if one node is failed, it does not affect the whole network. For example, if computer C stops working, then it has no effect on the other computers or other nodes attached to the same network. Now let's discuss the disadvantages of bus topology. It is not suitable for large network. The bus topology is suitable only for small networks. If central wire means bus, is failed, the whole network is failed. As all nodes send their messages to this central wire, so if this central wire is corrupted, then the communication is not possible. Let's discuss the star topology. All nodes are connected to a central device. This is the central device. And this central device can be a hub or a switch. Hub and switch both are hardware devices that are used to connect different computers or nodes of a network. In this diagram, you can see every computer is connected to this central device. They are not directly connected to each other, but with the central device. Now let's see how communication is made in star topology. Suppose that this computer is computer A and it wants to communicate with this computer, which is E computer. Like bus topology, the central computer has to send two types of information to this central device. Its message or data and address of the destination computer. Now this message will be sent by computer A to this central device, and then this central device will check the message and address of the destination computer, and instead of sending message to all computers, this device will send message to the destination computer only, which is computer E. This is how communication is made in star network or star topology. Now let's see the advantages and disadvantages of star topology. If one node is failed, it doesn't affect the whole network. For example, if this computer stops working, then still other computers can communicate to each other using this central device. So the failure of one computer doesn't affect the whole network. Second advantage is it is a very flexible network. Flexible means it is very simple to remove a node from the network or adding a node to the network. And the disadvantage of star topology is if the central device fails, the whole network is failed, as the communication in star topology depends on the central device. And if central device is not working, the communication is not possible in the star topology. Now let's move to the ring topology. As the name suggests, ring. All devices or nodes in the ring topology are arranged in a ring shape. Every computer is connected to the next computer. As you can see, this computer is connected to this computer. So every computer is connected to the next computer until the last computer is connected to the first computer. In this diagram, it's our last computer and it was our first computer. So first computer is attached to the last computer, hence making a ring shape. Now let's discuss the working of ring topology. If this computer wants to communicate with this computer, suppose it is computer A and it is computer D. A will send its message along with the address of destination computer. A will send this message to the computer B. As the destination address is not matched with B, so the computer B will send its message to the computer C. It will simply forward the message to the computer C. But as this message is not for computer C, so it will send it to the next computer, which is computer D. Here the destination address is matched, so this computer will keep the message and communication will stop here. Now let's see what are the advantages and disadvantages of ring topology. Advantages: it is less expensive than star topology. As in the star topology, we used a central device which is not used in the ring topology. So the ring topology saves expenses. The second advantage is ring topology is very easy to install and maintain. Now let's see the disadvantages of ring topology. Failure of one node can affect the whole network. For example, suppose the computer C has stopped working. If A wants to communicate with D, then the message sent by A will stop at this point, as C is corrupted, so it will neither receive the message from computer B nor will forward it to the next computer, which is the destination computer of this message. So in a ring topology, if one node fails, it may affect the whole network. The second disadvantage is it is difficult to add or remove computers from the network. The next topology is tree topology. Tree topology combines the features of bus topology and star topology. In a tree network, different star networks are connected to a central bus. Look at this diagram. In this diagram, there are three star networks. One star network, two, and this is the third star network, which are connected to a central bus. This star network is connected to the central bus. This is also connected to this central bus. This central wire is known as bus. As we discussed in the bus topology, there were different nodes attached to the central wire, which we named as a bus. So, in the tree topology, this is the central bus and different star networks are connected to this central bus. Tree topology is the hybrid of bus topology and star topology. As the tree topology combines the feature of bus topology and star topology, therefore, the advantages and disadvantages of tree topology are almost similar to the advantages and disadvantages of star topology and bus topology. Advantage of tree topology is it is very flexible. Addition or removal of computer or node in this network is very easy. And the disadvantage of tree network is if this central bus is failed, the whole network stops working. Now let's see the working of tree topology. If this computer wants to communicate with this computer, then it will send its message along with the destination address of this computer to this central device. And then central device will forward this message to the central bus, and bus will move this message to the relevant star network. Then after reaching the message at this point to this central device, and then this central device will forward this message to the destination computer. Now let's discuss the mesh topology. In the mesh topology, every device is connected to all other devices of the same network. For example, this device, it is connected to all other devices of this network. For example, it is connected to this device, this device, and this device. As there are 1, 2, 3, 4 other nodes connected to this network, so this computer has 4 outgoing connections. Similarly, if we talk about this computer, so it is connected to all other devices. And if we talk about this computer, it is also connected to all other devices. So in the mesh topology, every device is connected to all other devices of the same network. In the mesh topology, message can be sent using multiple paths. For example, if A wants to communicate with computer B, then there are many paths from node A to node B that can be used to send message from A to B, such as A can use this path to communicate with this node, or the message can be sent from A to B using this path and many other paths as well. And that is the major advantage of mesh topology. There are multiple links to communicate. So if one channel or link is damaged, for example, if this link is damaged, then still computer A can send its message to computer B using this channel or using this channel. The second advantage is it supports heavy load. Now let's discuss disadvantages. A mesh network is a very complex network. There are many paths and there are many wires in this network that makes it very complex. And this network is also very expensive, as many wires are used in this network for connecting one device with all other devices. It was all about network topology. Thank you for watching. For more ICS Computer Science lectures for Part 1 and Part 2, subscribe to my channel.